Robert, how are you doing today?
Excellent.
Fantastic. Happy to hear it. Congratulations on the movie. Really enjoyed it. Okay. I'm going to tell everyone I know to see it on as big a screen as they possibly can, because it's fantastic to look at. when it comes to a film this big, how do you personally begin a project like this? Because there's just so many parts to it. Like, what do you decide, this is what I'm going to focus on first?
The very first thing I started doing was just drawing out storyboards for some of the key sequences.
In fact,
we had just taken it to Fox, and Jim came down to my house in my studio to check it out. And we went to my house. I made him some pizza, and I said, "You want to watch 15 minutes of the movie?" And he's like, "What?" I said, "I already cut together the bar fight and some motorball and this from my storyboards with sound effects and music, and it's like what it feels like you're watching the movie."
Sure.
Because it's got the sound effects and everything. And he could say, he could make comments on it. So he's like, "Wow." I said, "I had to get started right away." This was the end of 2015.
Wow.
And some of those shots finally just dropped in like a week ago.
Wow.
So that's how long it took. So I had to get started right away. I focused on the ones that were the biggest scene. I did that on Sin City too. I went right at the scenes that were the most complex, and I tried to figure those out first, because then everything else after that was kind of just rolls down easier.
When it comes to big budget sci-fi, like James obviously knows that genre inside and out, because Avatar is the biggest film of all time. And there are certain other movies like Inception and The Martian that do really, really well. But there's also the flip side where they have, say, Jupiter Ascending, or, you know, this really big original sci-fi stuff that I believe Alita is quite different to everything else in the big screen. What that don't stick the landing. Do you have any inkling as to why some do and some don't?
Yeah, they didn't have Jim Cameron.
he's the secret weapon.
He's the secret weapon. I mean, it's why he has some of the biggest movies of all time. The other movies that are the biggest of all time, they didn't come from writer-directors.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so he sees the whole picture. I've known him 25 years, and I can tell you, I still don't know how he does it. I wanted to work with him so I could get a peek behind the curtain to see what the trick is. And the trick is there's no trick. The guy's just actually a genius. And it's like blows your mind. It's humbling, but it's also exciting to be around people like that.
Yeah.
Because he can literally see around a corner. I mean, like, you follow him going, "What are you talking about?" Oh, I mean, it's like magic.
He sees what
And his story was already so well crafted, and it didn't fall into the pitfall of it being just sci-fi, futuristic, cyborg. It was like, oh, this is like a story that's very timeless that you can play to any audience member, even if they don't know what a manga is. They can like get into this story because it's about the human element. And what makes a great picture, what makes a great movie, science fiction or otherwise, like, is this, or especially a science fiction fantasy, is the mix of truth and spectacle. The spectacle's why you go.
Yeah.
But you're gonna walk away taking home with you the human element, the truth, the human truth of it. And that's what this had so much of.
Yeah.
That I got me really excited about it and made me want to make it with him.
When it came to the specific visual palette, because that's another thing about science fiction, if you go like too rainy and neon, then everyone's just going to be like, oh, it's just it's Blade Runner. Or if you go too the other way, it's like, oh, it's just Mad Max Fury Road. Like, how difficult is it to strike the balance where maybe you are paying homage to certain sci-fi, but also you want to create your own specific image? And as there was there anything that you were like, this is kind of borrowing from that?
Yeah, no, this thing felt original in that it was, and it was just because of a scientific reason. Originally, it was set more like in a Kansas City type place in the manga. But Jim moved it to the equator because, in his mind, you know, a space elevator would only really work close to the equator, which put it like in Panama City. And I was like, really? Well, that's cool, because that gives us like a Latin country look to this sci-fi, which you've never seen before. But that's not why he put it there. It was just for scientific reasons only. But it gave us a color palette and just of a look that was very different, more relatable. And that was the other thing, too. You wanted to make it more relatable than some sci-fi movies where they're so far in the future. And this is 600 years in the future that you can't really relate to it. And it feels too foreign. And then almost like, you detach emotionally from that, where here it feels so relatable that it feels like a story that's part of a reflection of who we are.
And one final question, it can be yes or no if you like. If this does fantastically well, which I really hope it does, would you come back and direct the sequel, or are you like, after 4 years I need to take a little break and then
I mean, it didn't really feel like 4 years. I mean, it really was a fun journey, and we would definitely, I mean, if everyone please and go see it, we would love to make more. I mean, you saw the ending. It just it's just a roll. It's just a drum roll into another movie.
Yeah, at the end, I was like, "Damn you, Robert!"
I mean, it gives a very complete story. Now she knows who she is, but you have to.
You want more.
You want more. You definitely, and you would, and it would be such a cool way to follow into the next worlds through her eyes, because now she's so relatable that the other worlds won't feel so foreign because you're seeing it through her eyes. She'll be experiencing it first time too. So I think she's a good window into these kind of movies that normally would leave us a little bit more cold.
Absolutely.
Because they get so out there. You can go pretty out there because you've got her mm-hmm. walking you through. So that would be fun.
Well, I hope it does. I really look forward to any sequels you might do. Robert, thank you so much.
She's threatening the natural order of things. I need you to destroy her.
Alita, they will come for you.
I'll have to face them head on. I'm gonna need you to stand way back.
Tonight is not a game. It is a hunt.
With her.